The leading cause of death among premature infants is still lung disease of prematurity, which is because of the deficiency of surfactant in the premature lung. Over time, this disease can progress into chronic lung disease that is seen in premature infants, also known as bronchopulmonary dysplasia, and its associated issues such as pulmonary hypertension. We also treat a large number of infants who are referred from various centers in the state and beyond with congenital anomalies of the lung, such as diaphragmatic hernia or other lung conditions that may affect the newborn. The second leading cause of death in premature infants is the intestinal conditions, such as necrotizing enterocolitis, and certain conditions that a baby might be born with, such as Hirschsprung's disease or gastroschisis. In some of these infants, the intestine might not function normally for prolonged periods of time or might be anatomically short, causing these infants to stay in a neonatal ICU-like setting for several weeks to months. The third set of conditions which continue to affect neonatal survival are the brain disorders, which might be secondary to birth asphyxia, intracranial bleeds, because of seizures, and we also see a large number of these infants who have encephalopathy because of congenital, genetic, or metabolic conditions. The fourth set is related to cardiac conditions, which may be because of congenital anomalies of the heart or major blood vessels that may require surgery within the newborn period, or at least major stabilization that would eventually pave the way to safe surgery. The fifth condition is affecting the kidney, and these infants may either be born with kidney anomalies or might develop kidney failure because of their critical illness. In addition, we are increasingly seeing a large number of newborns with complex genetic or multi-system conditions that require multidisciplinary care. The Johns Hopkins Children's Center houses the Sutlin Pakula Newborn Critical Care Center, which is a state-of-the-art facility to provide multidisciplinary care to medically and surgically complex newborn infants. At this center, we work very closely with obstetricians who specialize in maternal fetal medicine or in fetal care. We also work very closely with pediatric subspecialists who provide care to infants with diagnoses related to the heart, the brain, the kidney, and various other organs. A major benefit of care at Johns Hopkins Children's Center is that you have access to not only the latest in medical and surgical therapy, but you also have access to all the latest research that is going on in various medical and surgical fields. The Division of Neonatology at Johns Hopkins Children's Center includes several nationally and internationally renowned experts who treat infants with conditions affecting the brain, the lung, and the intestine. We also work very closely with subspecialists who provide care to infants for cardiac, renal, neurological, genetic, and various other conditions. For instance, if a baby has suffered birth asphyxia, we not only provide the latest whole body cooling programs, but we also have intensive state-of-the-art monitoring programs that may not be available universally. Along with our obstetricians, our division is probably one of the most experienced in the entire United States in providing care to fetuses that may have complex congenital anomalies that may require treatment even before birth. These may include twins or multiple fetuses that may have abnormalities of the placenta. They may have congenital diaphragmatic hernia, neural tube defects, or urinary abnormalities. Care at Johns Hopkins Children's Center brings you not only the state-of-the-art treatment given for medical and surgical conditions that affect newborn infants, but our efforts are also to bring you access to all the latest research that is being conducted at this institution, and yet ensure that our care remains patient-focused and family-centered. Thank you. If a baby requires a complex surgical procedure, the family will typically meet with neonatologists, surgeons who might specialize in general pediatric procedures, or in one of the organ-based subspecialized surgical programs. In these discussions, we also typically have obstetricians who specialize in maternal fetal medicine or fetal care, and also pediatric anesthesiologists. One of the major strengths at Johns Hopkins Children's Center is the close interaction between pediatric anesthesiologists and the critical care specialists that work together in the pediatric ICU. After the baby has undergone a surgical procedure, the infant may receive initial care in the pediatric ICU for initial stabilization and recovery. In our experience, this improves the safety of these procedures and improves outcomes. Once the baby has recovered to a reasonable extent, the baby then gets transferred back to the neonatal ICU for subsequent care. Our goal is to provide the most comprehensive care to your infant at a site which is most convenient to the family. If a baby has a complex medical or surgical condition, the initial care might have to be at Johns Hopkins Children's Center. But once the baby has recovered to a reasonable degree, subsequent care can be provided at Johns Hopkins Bayview Medical Center, Johns Hopkins Howard County General Hospital, or at Frederick Memorial Hospital. Each of these sites is staffed by neonatologists who are part of the same division of neonatology at Johns Hopkins Children's Center. Once the baby has stabilized for routine care, the baby can most often be transferred to one of the institutions that partner with us across the state. Our division has major research strengths in neurological conditions, particularly birth asphyxia, neonatal encephalopathy, and seizures, where we provide state-of-the-art treatment and monitoring regimens. We also have significant expertise in intestinal conditions such as necrotizing enterocolitis, Hirschsprung's disease, and gastroschisis, which are major causes of morbidity and mortality in newborn infants. In addition, there are leaders who perform research in neonatal immunology, infectious disease, communication, and quality and safety. Our goal is to provide comprehensive, multidisciplinary care to infants with complex medical and surgical conditions. In this effort, we work closely with obstetricians who specialize in maternal fetal medicine and fetal therapy, and with all the medical and surgical pediatric subspecialists. We understand the kind of stress a situation like this can impose on both the family and the referring team, and our efforts will be always to communicate clearly with both and provide all support that we can. If I can be of help, please feel free to reach out to me personally. Thank you.
Yes.